Welcome you all to the course EC8553 Discrete Time Signal Processing. This lecture is about design of digital filter from analog filter examples. In the previous lecture we discussed how to get the digital filter transfer function from analog filter transfer function based on impulse invariance, bilinear and approximation derivative. Here we are going to solve some examples for the better understanding. Consider question number 1. Determine h of z using impulse invariance method at 5 hertz sampling frequency from h of s is equal to 2 divided by s plus 1 into s plus 2. They are given analog transfer function. We have to convert into digital transfer function by use of impulse invariance transform method. And they mention the sampling frequency is 5 hertz. Indirectly, they are given sampling period. Okay. To proceed further, so take the h of s and do the partial fraction and separate the products. So h of s is equal to 2 by s plus 1 into s plus 2 and do the partial fraction, that is a by s plus 1 plus b by s plus 2, and find the values of a and b. So I'm getting b is equal to minus 2 and a is equal to plus 2. And I can able to write the h of s as 2 divided, that is a by s plus 1, the value of a is equal to 2, and b by s plus 2, the value of b is equal to minus 2. Now it is in the form of c divided by s plus alpha. If it is in the form of c by s plus alpha, in the previous lecture I gave the formula for c by s plus alpha is nothing but c divided by 1 minus e to the power of alpha into t into z inverse. And the value of the pole location is minus 1, the pole location is minus 2. So c divided by 1 minus e to the power of p, that is pole value, minus 1 into t value. If t is not given, we can take t is equal to 1 second. But in this problem, they mention the sampling frequency. So the sampling period t is nothing but the reciprocal of sampling frequency, that is 1 by 5. 1 by 5 is equal to 0.2. Take the value t as 0.2 and substitute into z inverse. Similarly for the second term. Now you can able to calculate e to the power of minus 0.2 in your calculator and find the value. So the final h of z is equal to 2 divided by 1 minus 0.819 z inverse minus 2 divided by 1 minus 0.67 z inverse. Now we can do the cross multiplication or LCM and find the final answer. Since the given h of s analog transfer function is second order, the digital transfer function also will be a second order system. And this is the final h of z, that is 0.298 z divided by z square minus 1.488 z plus 0.54. And one more point. If I see the h of s, the poles are located at minus 1 and minus 2, which are lying at the left side of s plane. Then if I see the corresponding h of z, the poles are located at 0.819 as well as 0.67. They are the pole locations which is lying inside the unit circle. The analog stable system is converted into digital stable system by use of impulse invariance. Now we'll move on to the question number 2. Apply bilinear transformation for the following h of s, 1 by s plus 1 into s plus 2. Assume t is equal to 1 seconds and find h of z. And they mentioned h of s and they have mentioned t also. We don't want to find the value. Simply we can take t is equal to 1 seconds. And we know that the bilinear transformation is nothing but s is equal to 2 by t, 1 minus z inverse divided by 1 plus z inverse, that has to be replaced in h of s to get h of z. So h of s, z is equal to 1 divided by s plus 1 into s plus 2. Instead of s, substitute 2 into 1 minus z inverse divided by 1 plus z inverse plus 1 into 2 into 1 minus z inverse divided by 1 plus z inverse plus 2. Then take the LCM and try to find out the answer in the order of 2. So the final answer is 1 plus z inverse the whole square divided by 4 into 3 minus z inverse. Now the example number 3. Convert the following H of S into H of Z using impulse invariance, bilinear and approximation derivatives for the H analog transfer function 1 divided by S square plus S plus 1. First we'll solve with impulse invariance. Since the sampling period is not mentioned, I have considered t is equal to 1 seconds. So since if I factorize this quadratic equation, I'm getting complex roots. So instead of doing that, I will go for completing the square. So S square plus S plus 1 can be rewritten as S square plus S plus 0.5 the whole square minus 0.5 the whole square to get a proper term. Now this can be written as S plus 1 by 2 the whole square plus 3 by 4. 3 by 4 is nothing but root 3 by 2 the whole square. We know the standard formula is nothing but B divided by S plus A the whole square plus B square. The value of B is nothing but root 3 by 2 here. That B is missing. So I am multiplying and dividing that value. So multiply by B and divide by B. So root 3 by 2 into 2 by root 3. Now if I check with the standard formula, this is looks like B divided by S plus A the whole square plus B square. The value of A is equal to 1 by 2. The value of B is equal to root 3 by 2. The standard formula says Z into e power minus A into T into sine B into T. Since the value of T is equal to 1, it is e to the power of minus 1 by 2 into sine into root 3 by 2 into 1. Whole divided by Z square minus 2Z e power minus AT cos BT. Once again T is equal to 1, substitute the value of A and B plus e power minus 2AT. A is equal to 1 by 2, T is equal to 1, 2 into 1 by 2 is 1. Now find the values of sine root 3 by 2, cos root 3 by 2. Keep your calc in radian mode and find the value. And the final answer is H of Z is equal to 2 divided by root 3, 0.462 Z whole divided by Z square minus 0.786 Z plus 0.368. And the second approach is for the same problem, bilinear. They mention H of S is equal to 1 by S square plus S plus 1. Just replace S is equal to 2 by T, where T is equal to 1. So 2 into 1 minus Z inverse by 1 plus Z inverse, or otherwise S is equal to 2 by T Z minus 1 divided by Z plus 1. Both are same. Now replace S is equal to so and so, then minimize. The final answer is H of Z is equal to Z plus 1 the whole square divided by 7Z square minus 6Z plus 3. This is the corresponding digital transfer function if I follow bilinear. The last method is approximation derivatives. So once again T is equal to 1 seconds, and we know that approximation derivative is nothing but we have to replace S is equal to 1 minus Z inverse divided by T in the analog transfer function to get digital transfer function. So H of Z is equal to H of S at S is equal to 1 minus Z inverse. Just replace wherever S is there and minimize. The final transfer function I'm getting here is H of Z is equal to Z square divided by 3Z square minus 3Z plus 1. So this is three different approaches for the same problem. So initially we discussed how to solve with impulse invariance and bilinear. Now the third one is approximation derivatives. Next, practice questions for the students. Here I have given three questions. The first one, H of S is equal to 10 divided by S square plus 7S plus 10. Design a digital filter equivalent to this using impulse invariant method. Okay, and they mention the sampling period is 0.2 seconds. Check whether this is we'll get the distinct roots. Okay, S square plus 7S plus 10. I think we can go for S plus 5 and S plus 2. So the roots are distinct. So do the Fourier fraction and follow the formula and substitute is equal to 0.2 and get the digital transfer function. And problem number 2, design a third order Butterworth digital filter using impulse invariant technique. Assume sampling period T is equal to 1 second. Since the order is mentioned, we'll have a predefined transfer function for third order Butterworth. H of s is equal to 1 divided by s plus 1 into s square plus s plus 1. This transfer function will not give the proper distinct roots. Obviously, that will give the complex roots. So better we'll go with either second order formula, s plus a divided by s plus a the whole square plus b square format, or b divided by s plus a the whole square plus b square. So based on the problem, you can choose any one formula. And the third one is, they mention h of s is equal to 2 divided by s plus 3 into s plus 2. Determine h of z using impulse invariant and bilinear transform. Okay. And they directly given h of s. There are two different distinct roots. The roots are s plus 3 and s plus 2. So we have to convert into h of z by use of impulse. I think it is, once again, we can go for partial fraction and separate the terms, apply the formula. But here the condition is, they mention the sampling frequency fs is equal to 10 hertz. Then the sampling period should be 1 by 10, that is 0.1 seconds. Similarly, by use of bilinear, we can able to find h of z. There also we can solve s is equal to 2 by t, 1 minus z inverse by 1 plus z inverse, or 2 by t, z minus 1 divided by z plus 1. Hope you understand. Thanks for the session.